galactic family. I will talk about the illusion. The illusion is like a dream because it is created by the power of thought. The illusion you live in physically in your waking state exists in many different aspects and nuances, all created and shaped by each individual. This is why individuals who have witnessed the same event can retell in a number of different ways, and this is also why each individual can change their story after a while. The illusion is the individual's perception of reality, and this is influenced by a number of factors. For example, 1. The individual's past and what it carries in its baggage in the form of experiences and trials. 2. The individual's balance for the moment. The inner balance and the moon are affected by how reality is perceived. It is also a reason why a retold experience can change. A new moon changes perspective. 3. Personal development is extremely relevant to the context. If the individual is trained to look beyond their own perceived limitations, the individual can also retell the experience in a version close to the version of reality. Man interprets and retells according to his version. This is no difference for the individuals who have contact with their mentors, as is happening at the moment. My channel in this now hears me, sees me, feels me and makes her interpretation based on what she is in this now. So then I come to the much discussed question, what is illusion and what is reality? Everything is an illusion and everything is reality. You say that what is seen does not exist. I, Saint Germain, for example, who does not possess a physical body right now and is therefore considered to belong to the illusion, a fantasy. But when a person recounts an event that does not match another person's recounting of the same event, it is considered that one is lying. See instead that even in that case it is about the inner vision. I see what I want to see and I make my own individual interpretation. As much an illusion as I, Saint Germain, or I am as much for real as what you call physical experience. Everything is inside the viewer's interior. Always remember that before you judge someone, call someone a liar. Remember that the outcome of a fellow human being's action depends on how you receive what you choose to see or hear. A word that you may perceive as malicious may not have been meant that way at all, but it was your interpretation of it all. In this way, we all live in the illusion that few people have the absolute purity to see and interpret reality exactly as it is. The illusion contains the trials of your life, and these trials ease when you can see in your heart what it is really about, what it is in you that reacts. So continue with your development, a little at a time, and understand that as you develop, your view of the illusion also changes and you get closer and closer to the truth. Closer and closer to inner peace and enjoyment of life. You are likely angry, afraid, and feeling vulnerable. Not because you need to, but because your being is shifting so rapidly, you feel the need to hold on to what you once knew, including holiday celebrations. Even if you were to celebrate this holiday season as you did in 3D, you would feel out of place. Your words would be a bit scrambled, and your actions not necessarily as you or others expect. You have difficulties acknowledging you are evolving rapidly, that nothing that was is any longer. So even if you replicated the most joyful 3D holiday season you ever experienced, it would fall short of your expectations. You are no longer you. Nor are your friends and relatives who they were. You can label that uncomfortable feeling politics, COVID, or anything you wish that is outside your being. But the truth is, you are different. Think of celebrating the holidays as an 8-year-old and an adult. Different joys, different experiences, and different activities. So it is for you. Because you are no longer of 3D, you cannot recreate or fully enjoy any 3D experience. In truth, many of you pine for Hollywood's holiday version even though you may never have experienced it. So it was for your 3D lives. You had 3D expectations that were never fully met. Perhaps the expectations of a few Earth beings were met. But even they suffered or responded according to social rules. Do this during the holidays, even though you are exhausted. Do this on this birthday and that on this designated special day. Such, of course, will be different in the future. The joy of your new life is that you can create anew. For is not the story of the Hollywood holidays one of love and joy? Many of you want to know how you are changing and what will bring you joy. Again, looking outside yourself for answers and directions. Even though such is the 3D way, it is unknown to any dimension beyond 3D. For you are the master of yourself. So it is 2020 has allowed you to stop and reevaluate your actions and interests. Before this year, many of you expected that stop to happen in a flash. You would have been upset knowing you would be housebound or curtailed in certain ways from continuing your 3D life even though you are no longer of 3D. It was a grand plan designed by Young Mass to stop your world in ways you would never have agreed to consciously. This year and some months beyond have been the great awakening or ascension many have waited for. Some of you are now concerned you did not make the most of this time. That despite all, you continued your 3D activities, perhaps even thoughts. Such concerns are to be expected for 3D personal, negative judgment has been rampant throughout your 3D lives. Your interest in reading this material should inform you that you are much more advanced in your new life than you now believe. So are millions of others. And by the beginning of 2021, all of you will be even more advanced in thought and action. Allow yourself to feel the joy of achieving all you wish to achieve in 2020, knowing you built your beyond 3D structure. And that 2021 will enhance that structure based on your interests and joys. You have or soon will be creating that which is most important to you, not to impress your family or friends, but because doing so provides joy and contentment. Some of you have also discovered what you no longer wish to do. Perhaps you no longer wish to work from home. Perhaps you have discovered a new business model, a need to nurture yourself or to help others. It does not matter. There are no longer any right answers, only your answers. A concept that is difficult for many of you. Because you are not necessarily certain what your answers are. You wish to reenact the joys of 3D without the possibility of doing so. And you continue to discover answers to what your new life and, therefore, joys might be. You are in a personal void as you likely have been for some months, confusing you and others. Know that by the end of 2020, your clarity, as well as those awakened or awakening, will be more finite. For 2021 is about adding to your structure. This year, 2020, was about the destruction of 3D structures and pouring the foundation of your new life. In 2021, you will create the framework for your new life and new world. This Galactic Federation has supposedly been in contact with Israel and the US for years, but are keeping themselves a secret to prevent hysteria until humanity is ready. Has the State of Israel made contact with aliens? According to retired Israeli general and current professor Haim Esht, the answer is yes, but this has been kept a secret because humanity isn't ready. Speaking in an interview to Yediot Aharonot, Esht, who served as the head of Israel's space security program for nearly 30 years and is a three-time recipient of the Israel Security Award, explained that Israel and the U.S. have both been dealing with aliens for years. And this by no means refers to immigrants, with Esht clarifying the existence of a Galactic Federation. The 87-year-old former space security chief gave further descriptions about exactly what sort of agreements have been made between the aliens and the U.S., which ostensibly have been made because they wish to research and understand the fabric of the universe. This cooperation includes a secret underground base on Mars, where there are American and alien representatives. If true, this would coincide with U.S. President Donald Trump's creation of the Space Force as the fifth branch of the U.S. Armed Forces, though it is unclear how long this sort of relationship, if any, has been going on between the U.S. and its reported extraterrestrial allies. But Est insists that Trump is aware of them, and that he was on the verge of disclosing their existence. However, the Galactic Federation reportedly stopped him from doing so, saying they wished to prevent mass hysteria since they felt humanity needed to evolve and reach a stage where we will understand what space and spaceships are, Yediot Aharonot reported. As for why he's chosen to reveal this information now, Asht explained that the timing was simply due to how much the academic landscape has changed, and how respected he is in academia. If I had come up with what I'm saying today 5 years ago, I would have been hospitalized, he explained to Yediot. He added that today, they're already talking differently. I have nothing to lose. I've received my degrees and awards. I am respected in universities abroad, where the trend is also changing. Esh provided more information in his newest book, The Universe Beyond the Horizon: Conversations with Professor Chaim Esht, along with other details such as how aliens have prevented nuclear apocalypses and when we can jump in and visit the Men in Black. While it is unclear if any evidence exists that could support Esht's claims, they did come just ahead of a recent announcement by SpaceHill, the group behind Israel's failed attempt to land a spacecraft on the moon in 2019. Uploaded to social media with the text "Ready to get excited again?" The announcement contained a 15-second video of the moon with text saying "Back to the moon," followed by the date of December 9, 2020. It is likely that this is a follow-up to the Beersheet spacecraft, which crashed after engineers lost contact with it just minutes before it was due to land. However, the follow-up project, titled Beersheet 2, is expected to take 3 years to be ready. We have been exploring the consciousness of humanity for long enough to know when you are in a period of tremendous growth, and you are in one of those periods right now. When you experience tremendous growth, you can have different experiences as individuals, and those experiences will depend on whether you have completed the work that you've wanted to do on yourselves, or whether you've not been able to for one reason or another. If you have completed the vast majority of the work, then a growth cycle looks like expansion. It looks like you being able to go further in your relationships, in your career, and in your spirituality than ever before. You ride the wave. If you are one of the ones who hasn't been doing so much work on themselves, then the wave crashes into you and pulls you under. Therefore, we can see how a lot of people at this time would be experiencing some intense growing pains. Now, from your perspective, riding the wave is much better than getting buried by it, but those who have been buried get to have the experience of getting up. And once you get up and dust yourselves off, you can and you will get to the good part of the growth experience. We have seen it time and time again. We know that it's so important for all of you to just be there and to keep getting up when you are knocked down. We also know that for many it seems like the number of times and the number of ways in which you can be knocked down is infinite. But trust us when we say that it does end eventually, and you will all be riding the waves of the energies to the new expanded versions of yourselves and the rest of humankind. What you want to focus on right now is the fact that growth is happening. What you want to do, in every moment that you can remember to do so, is try to keep up by letting go. Now, keeping up by letting go may seem like a paradox, but we promise you that it works. Acceptance works. Surrender works. Letting go of attachments works, and they work because your ascension is inevitable. The only thing that makes your ascension a rocky ride is when you're holding on to something that is heavy, something that is weighing you down, something that is old and familiar, yet limiting. It's time for all of you to let go of all that is limiting you and to realize the potential that you have within you at all times to become your higher selves, to go beyond where humanity has ever gone before. This is a huge feat, a huge undertaking, and one that is worth getting up time and time again for. We are feeling into the collective consciousness of humanity to determine whether you are ready for even more upgrades and activations. We see all of you as our partners in this, because those of you who are awake demonstrate an ability to handle so much energy and information, and you are also the ones who spread it around. You elevate the consciousness of your entire human race, and you do so without much effort at all. You do so when you meditate. You do so when you open yourselves up. You do so when you relax and let in all that we, and others like us, have sent to you to help elevate that consciousness of yours. We know that there are so many on your world right now who are just waiting and wishing for ETS to land their ships all over your planet to bail humanity out. We know that the vast majority of humans would rather just have all of your issues solved in the blink of an eye than to have a long journey towards the promised land. But when you do look back at your journeys, you are going to be so very happy because ETS went about helping you in more subtle ways. You are going to take a lot of satisfaction in knowing that you were the ones to bring about the real change that you want to see on your world. You will be very happy to know that it was your ability to open yourselves up and receive that led to the massive changes that you have coming. And we also want to say to you that one massive change at a time is going to be far more satisfying, and you will be able to savor those changes so much more because you were not overwhelmed. And if you could be overwhelmed, imagine what those who have yet to awaken would experience. That is why we have to take the temperature of the consciousness to see how well you all who are awake there have done with what we have already given you. There is so much more, and ultimately it is not up to us anyway when you receive it. Your higher selves are the ones who are really in charge. We are just the delivery system that we all set up before we started to play this game of existing in this universe. We invite you to relax more, to open up, and to receive all that is available to you, and then spread it around some more so that we can do what we do best and empower you to do what you do best. We are available to all of you in every moment of every day, and so are your guides. So is Source, your Oversoul, and your Higher Self, all the Archangels, all the Ascended Masters, your soul family that exists in other parts of the galaxy and the universe. They are all available to you as well. And then there's your planet, the other planets in your system, your sun, nature, trees, flowers, and animals. You are surrounded by love. You are surrounded by support. But many of you look for that love and support in places where it isn't. You look for it in human beings who never received it themselves, who turned to some sort of addiction at some point in their teens or twenties, and who never got the opportunity to go and see a therapist, or someone who could help them to love themselves. This is a fatal flaw amongst humans. When you look for love and support in those who do not have it to give, you set yourselves up for a disastrous experience. So we suggest that you don't ask anyone to be that for you when they are having a hard enough time being it for themselves. Instead, feel for all the love and support that you have all around you in non-human form, fill yourselves up with it, and go out and spread it around. When you spread love and support around, guess what happens? You find yourself in the company of other people who are spreading love and support around. When you go looking for it in other people, you tend to find other people who are also looking for it. And certainly, Most of you have been in a romantic relationship that was like that at some point, and you know exactly what we mean. You can feel an infinite amount of love flowing through you for a cat, and you can feel that love coming back to you as well. It is unconditional, and there is more where that came from. There is an infinite fountain of love that can be tapped into by all of you. Once you discover that it is all around you, it's easier to tap into the infinite fountain that is within you. It is easier to be heart-centered. Please do yourselves a favor and stop trying to fix the people in your lives so that they can love you the way that you want to be loved, and instead, ask yourself why you don't just be the love that you want to receive. Love is free. Love is infinite, and it is fundamentally unconditional, so please don't hold back. The world needs you to be that love more today than it has ever needed you before, and you are the ones who know that what we are saying is true. You are the ones who know that Source doesn't withhold love from anyone, ever, no matter what they do, and you know that you are there to be like Source. The illusion is like a dream because it is created by the power of thought. The illusion you live in physically in your waking state exists in many different aspects and nuances, all created and shaped by each individual. This is why individuals who have witnessed the same event can retell in a number of different ways, and this is also why each individual can change their story after a while. The illusion is the individual's perception of reality, and this is influenced by a number of factors. For example, 1. The individual's past and what it carries in its baggage in the form of experiences and trials. 2. The individual's balance for the moment. The inner balance and the moon are affected by how reality is perceived. It is also a reason why a retold experience can change. A new moon changes perspective. 3. Personal development is extremely relevant to the context. If the individual is trained to look beyond their own perceived limitations, the individual can also retell the experience in a version close to the version of reality. Man interprets and retells according to his version. This is no difference for the individuals who have contact with their mentors as is happening at the moment. My channel in this now hears me, sees me, feels me and makes her interpretation based on what she is in this now. So then I come to the much discussed question, what is illusion and what is reality? Everything is an illusion and everything is reality. You say that what is seen does not exist. I, Saint Germain, for example, who does not possess a physical body right now and is therefore considered to belong to the illusion, a fantasy. But when a person recounts an event that does not match another person's recounting of the same event, it is considered that one is lying. See instead that even in that case it is about the inner vision. I see what I want to see and I make my own individual interpretation. As much an illusion as I, Saint Germain, or I am as much for real as what you call physical experience. Everything is inside the viewer's interior. Always remember that before you judge someone, call someone a liar. Remember that the outcome of a fellow human being's action depends on how you receive what you choose to see or hear. A word that you may perceive as malicious may not have been meant that way at all, but it was your interpretation of it all. In this way, we all live in the illusion that few people have the absolute purity to see and interpret reality exactly as it is. The illusion contains the trials of your life, and these trials ease when you can see in your heart what it is really about, what it is in you that reacts. So continue with your development, a little at a time, and understand that as you develop, your view of the illusion also changes and you get closer and closer to the truth. Closer and closer to inner peace and enjoyment of life. You are likely angry, afraid, and feeling vulnerable. Not because you need to, but because your being is shifting so rapidly, you feel the need to hold on to what you once knew, including holiday celebrations. Even if you were to celebrate this holiday season as you did in 3D, you would feel out of place. Your words would be a bit scrambled, and your actions not necessarily as you or others expect. You have difficulties acknowledging you are evolving rapidly, that nothing that was is any longer. So even if you replicated the most joyful 3D holiday season you ever experienced, it would fall short of your expectations. You are no longer you. Nor are your friends and relatives who they were. You can label that uncomfortable feeling politics, COVID, or anything you wish that is outside your being. But the truth is, you are different. Think of celebrating the holidays as an 8-year-old and an adult. Different joys, different experiences, and different activities. So it is for you. Because you are no longer of 3D, you cannot recreate or fully enjoy any 3D experience. In truth, many of you pine for Hollywood's holiday version even though you may never have experienced it. So it was for your 3D lives. You had 3D expectations that were never fully met. Perhaps the expectations of a few Earth beings were met. But even they suffered or responded according to social rules. Do this during the holidays, even though you are exhausted. Do this on this birthday and that on this designated special day. Such, of course, will be different in the future. The joy of your new life is that you can create anew. For is not the story of the Hollywood holidays, one of love and joy? Many of you want to know how you are changing and what will bring you joy. Again, looking outside yourself for answers and directions. Even though such is the 3D way, it is unknown to any dimension beyond 3D. For you are the master of yourself. So it is 2020 has allowed you to stop and reevaluate your actions and interests. Before this year, many of you expected that stop to happen in a flash. You would have been upset knowing you would be housebound or curtailed in certain ways from continuing your 3D life even though you are no longer of 3D. It was a grand plan designed by Young Mass to stop your world in ways you would never have agreed to consciously. This year and some months beyond have been the great awakening or ascension many have waited for. Some of you are now concerned you did not make the most of this time. That despite all, you continued your 3D activities, perhaps even thoughts. Such concerns are to be expected for 3D personal, negative judgment has been rampant throughout your 3D lives. Your interest in reading this material should inform you that you are much more advanced in your new life than you now believe. So are millions of others. And by the beginning of 2021, all of you will be even more advanced in thought and action. Allow yourself to feel the joy of achieving all you wish to achieve in 2020, knowing you built your beyond 3D structure. And that 2021 will enhance that structure based on your interests and joys. You have or soon will be creating that which is most important to you, not to impress your family or friends, but because doing so provides joy and contentment. Some of you have also discovered what you no longer wish to do. Perhaps you no longer wish to work from home. Perhaps you have discovered a new business model, a need to nurture yourself or to help others. It does not matter. There are no longer any right answers, only your answers. A concept that is difficult for many of you. Because you are not necessarily certain what your answers are. You wish to reenact the joys of 3D without the possibility of doing so. And you continue to discover answers to what your new life and, therefore, joys might be. You are in a personal void as you likely have been for some months, confusing you and others. Know that by the end of 2020, your clarity, as well as those awakened or awakening, will be more finite. For 2021 is about adding to your structure. This year, 2020, was about the destruction of 3D structures and pouring the foundation of your new life. In 2021, you will create the framework for your new life and new world. This Galactic Federation has supposedly been in contact with Israel and the US for years, but are keeping themselves a secret to prevent hysteria until humanity is ready. Has the State of Israel made contact with aliens? According to retired Israeli general and current professor Haim Esht, the answer is yes, but this has been kept a secret because humanity isn't ready. Speaking in an interview to Yediot Aharonot, Esht, who served as the head of Israel's space security program for nearly 30 years and is a three-time recipient of the Israel Security Award, explained that Israel and the U.S. have both been dealing with aliens for years. And this by no means refers to immigrants, with Esht clarifying the existence of a Galactic Federation. The 87-year-old former space security chief gave further descriptions about exactly what sort of agreements have been made between the aliens and the U.S., which ostensibly have been made because they wish to research and understand the fabric of the universe. This cooperation includes a secret underground base on Mars, where there are American and alien representatives. If true, this would coincide with U.S. President Donald Trump's creation of the Space Force as the fifth branch of the U.S. Armed Forces, though it is unclear how long this sort of relationship, if any, has been going on between the U.S. and its reported extraterrestrial allies. But Esht insists that Trump is aware of them, and that he was on the verge of disclosing their existence. However, the Galactic Federation reportedly stopped him from doing so, saying they wished to prevent mass hysteria since they felt humanity needed to evolve and reach a stage where we will understand what space and spaceships are, Yediot Aharonot reported. As for why he's chosen to reveal this information now, Esht explained that the timing was simply due to how much the academic landscape has changed, and how respected he is in academia. If I had come up with what I'm saying today 5 years ago, I would have been hospitalized, he explained to Yediot. He added that today, they're already talking differently. I have nothing to lose. I've received my degrees and awards. I am respected in universities abroad, where the trend is also changing. Esht provided more information in his newest book, The Universe Beyond the Horizon: Conversations with Professor Haim Esht, along with other details such as how aliens have prevented nuclear apocalypses and when we can jump in and visit the Man in Black. While it is unclear if any evidence exists that could support Esht's claims, they did come just ahead of a recent announcement by SpaceHill, the group behind Israel's failed attempt to land a spacecraft on the moon in 2019. Uploaded to social media with the text "Ready to get excited again?" The announcement contained a 15-second video of the moon with text saying "Back to the moon," followed by the date of December 9, 2020. It is likely that this is a follow-up to the Beersheet spacecraft, which crashed after engineers lost contact with it just minutes before it was due to land. However, the follow-up project, titled Beersheet 2, is expected to take 3 years to be ready. We have been exploring the consciousness of humanity for long enough to know when you are in a period of tremendous growth, and you are in one of those periods right now. When you experience tremendous growth, you can have different experiences as individuals, and those experiences will depend on whether you have completed the work that you've wanted to do on yourselves, or whether you've not been able to for one reason or another. If you have completed the vast majority of the work, then a growth cycle looks like expansion. It looks like you being able to go further in your relationships, in your career, and in your spirituality than ever before. You ride the wave. If you are one of the ones who hasn't been doing so much work on themselves, then the wave crashes into you and pulls you under. Therefore, we can see how a lot of people at this time would be experiencing some intense growing pains. Now, from your perspective, riding the wave is much better than getting buried by it, But those who have been buried get to have the experience of getting up. And once you get up and dust yourselves off, you can and you will get to the good part of the growth experience. We have seen it time and time again. We know that it's so important for all of you to just be there and to keep getting up when you are knocked down. We also know that for many it seems like the number of times and the number of ways in which you can be knocked down is infinite. But trust us when we say that it does end eventually, and you will all be riding the waves of the energies to the new expanded versions of yourselves and the rest of humankind. What you want to focus on right now is the fact that growth is happening. What you want to do, in every moment that you can remember to do so, is try to keep up by letting go. Now, keeping up by letting go may seem like a paradox, but we promise you that it works. Acceptance works. Surrender works. Letting go of attachments works, and they work because your ascension is inevitable. The only thing that makes your ascension a rocky ride is when you're holding on to something that is heavy, something that is weighing you down, something that is old and familiar, yet limiting. It's time for all of you to let go of all that is limiting you and to realize the potential that you have within you at all times to become your higher selves, to go beyond where humanity has ever gone before. This is a huge feat, a huge undertaking, and one that is worth getting up time and time again for. We are feeling into the collective consciousness of humanity to determine whether you are ready for even more upgrades and activations. We see all of you as our partners in this, because those of you who are awake demonstrate an ability to handle so much energy and information, and you are also the ones who spread it around. You elevate the consciousness of your entire human race, and you do so without much effort at all. You do so when you meditate. You do so when you open yourselves up. You do so when you relax and let in all that we, and others like us, have sent to you to help elevate that consciousness of yours. We know that there are so many on your world right now who are just waiting and wishing for ETS to land their ships all over your planet to bail humanity out. We know that the vast majority of humans would rather just have all of your issues solved in the blink of an eye than to have a long journey towards the promised land. But when you do look back at your journeys, you are going to be so very happy because ETS went about helping you in more subtle ways. You are going to take a lot of satisfaction in knowing that you were the ones to bring about the real change that you want to see on your world. You will be very happy to know that it was your ability to open yourselves up and receive that led to the massive changes that you have coming. And we also want to say to you that one massive change at a time is going to be far more satisfying, and you will be able to savor those changes so much more because you were not overwhelmed. And if you could be overwhelmed, imagine what those who have yet to awaken would experience. That is why we have to take the temperature of the consciousness to see how well you all who are awake there have done with what we have already given you. There is so much more, and ultimately it is not up to us anyway when you receive it. Your higher selves are the ones who are really in charge. We are just the delivery system that we all set up before we started to play this game of existing in this universe. We invite you to relax more, to open up, and to receive all that is available to you, and then spread it around some more so that we can do what we do best and empower you to do what you do best. We are available to all of you in every moment of every day, and so are your guides. So is Source, your Oversoul, and your Higher Self, all the Archangels, all the Ascended Masters, your soul family that exists in other parts of the galaxy and the universe. They are all available to you as well. And then there's your planet, the other planets in your system, your sun, nature, trees, flowers, and animals. You are surrounded by love. You are surrounded by support. But many of you look for that love and support in places where it isn't. You look for it in human beings who never received it themselves, who turn to some sort of addiction at some point in their teens or twenties, and who never got the opportunity to go and see a therapist, or someone who could help them to love themselves. This is a fatal flaw amongst humans. When you look for love and support in those who do not have it to give, you set yourselves up for a disastrous experience. So we suggest that you don't ask anyone to be that for you when they are having a hard enough time being it for themselves. Instead, feel for all the love and support that you have all around you in non-human form, fill yourselves up with it, and go out and spread it around. When you spread love and support around, guess what happens? You find yourself in the company of other people who are spreading love and support around. When you go looking for it in other people, you tend to find other people who are also looking for it. And certainly, most of you have been in a romantic relationship that was like that at some point, and you know exactly what we mean. You can feel an infinite amount of love flowing through you for a cat, and you can feel that love coming back to you as well. It is unconditional, and there is more where that came from. There is an infinite fountain of love that can be tapped into by all of you. Once you discover that it is all around you, it's easier to tap into the infinite fountain that is within you. It is easier to be heart-centered. Please do yourselves a favor and stop trying to fix the people in your lives so that they can love you the way that you want to be loved, and instead, ask yourself why you don't just be the love that you want to receive. Love is free. Love is infinite, and it is fundamentally unconditional, so please don't hold back. The world needs you to be that love more today than it has ever needed you before, and you are the ones who know that what we are saying is true. You are the ones who know that Source doesn't withhold love from anyone, ever, no matter what they do, and you know that you are there to be like Source.